Okay, the next discussion, I will explain about my research that I start about 2017, I think, when we try to develop our own environment when we want to collect the real big data from the sensor in the stream way, and then how we manage the data set. And then we came up with the result, yeah, something like that. So the idea is start in our laboratory. In that time, I have discussion with Pak Bambang Prastowo and then Pak Ahmad Asari also. We want focus in one of the subject. Yeah. We call it a natural disaster, but we will not came to the natural disaster that already happened in one region. Or in area, but what I want to do is how we have opportunity to see one area that have potential risk on natural disaster, and then we gather information before the natural disaster happen, so we can see the pattern, and then we wait until disaster happen, and then we have data collection in the very very wide range of type of data. So if we go to the data the area that already have the natural disaster, actually we already lost opportunity to gather the data before the event. So that's the main reason. So that's why we choose one area. It's not far from Jogja in that time. It's only about 3 hours from Jogja in the east. Yeah. It's called Wonogiri. Maybe one of you already know about this project, but we do this until now, yeah. So that's why it's, I want the nice one is this research is not only just research actually, but it's also the community development program. And the nice one is I can share with you as real. Real work on the field of the discussion in the lecturing event like this one, yeah. So we not only just discuss in the theory way, but also in the implementation, the real implementation. So I will give you some intro first. So this is like the situation in there, yeah. So actually, that regions is close with our place in Yogyakarta. It's about 2 until 3 hours drive with car, yeah. And the challenge is in that place we already have a lot of this we call it landslide event, yeah. So the landslide is already impact on the community because some of the road in there is gone, and then it's very make one village isolated in 1 month in that time. So this is the picture when I visit the place. If you know Mas Bagas, it also is IUP student. I don't know. I'm not forget the years, but he already graduated actually. But he one of the our coordinator in this project. Yeah, Bagas. I forget. Yeah, Bagas the big one. Yes. Yeah, the graduate. Yeah. He worked with me almost in 1 year. Joined this program. And he also lead the your friend, and we also invite many students from many program, not only from computer science, from psychology, from law, from philosophy, and etc. Working together, it's like KKN, but in KKN in a new way of KKN. So we work in 1 semester until 1 year, and then we develop the program, the tools in the campus, and then we bring there, and then we do the education, we do the mitigation, and also etc. So what the problem is like this one, the house in there is very close with the disaster area, and actually they realize it because it's like history, but you know, even we know that our area is the disaster area. They still live in that, yeah, because yeah, you know, it's the land of our grandfather. So yeah, you know, it's very we need to settle in there, and yeah, the problem is in every years the disaster is occurs, yeah, and is until today it still happen. And maybe in the several years ago, the disasters only came to the very 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 remote area, in that area too. But today is very close with the house, so that's the change of the disaster. So of course this is will be very dangerous for people in there. So this is the example how the landslide event in 2019. Yeah. We work together with the pemerintah desa in there, the village government in there. So we formulate the information in here. So if we found they found the incident, the event, landslide event like this one, they will report like this report, and will be broadcast to many things. Yeah, so that will be in the reporting. Yeah, but actually we already know because our sensor is already reported about this problem. Yeah, so this is the event, and then the event will be randomly, and then so that's why it's very challenging for us to do that one. So this is the main finding of that we discovered in that time. Yeah, of course landslide now has disrupt the life, make the life dangerous in there, and then it's always happen, especially in the early stage of winter period. Yeah, and then like this period, we have a heavy rain and so on, it will be more peak in the race. Yeah, and it's happened because the land and structure itself is very dangerous. It's have the potential, yeah, by default have the potential of landslide. And also we found in 2019, yeah, we work together with the lecturer from and researcher from geologies. They found the crack line, the ancient crack line of the, you know, we call the patahan kuno, gitu ya, patahan kuno yang that's make the landslide event more occur during the time. And this is the interesting one. When we go there, we found that we realized that a lot of history, data history, in from the event. But yeah, because I think Wonogiri is not one of the very centered city, so that's why the news and then the something like that is not big enough a benchmark with the other area, yeah. And then yeah, because they also have the government that always inspect the conditions. Actually, they already had inspection data for the current condition, but the inspection still using the manual way. So they deliver people go there to the field and then gather the information from the field. And also we have a lot of witness and report. When we talk with the old people in there, we will have a lot of story about the landslide event. Yeah, from the 1935, 1945, and then etc. Until now, they will tell the story in detail actually. And many landslide event, and also we have also the environment data and also the data, the spatial data. Yeah, so based on this data, actually in that time we have the idea. I think now the time of the big data and data science work in this field. Yeah, yeah, data science and big data is not only just work for the big city, for example, or industry, but it should be can be in this issue. So that's why that's the main focus of our two, yeah. So let's say I will skip this one first because we already discussed about it. So this is the journey. So what we do is, I forget, it's 2016 actually. We start this project and the G Connect. Yeah, G is about the Gamma Box. Yeah, Gamma Box Connects. The idea in that time when we go in that time in the first time, we realized that the area is very remote. Yeah, what I mean the remote is there is no with very limited data connectivity. The electricity power is also limited. Yeah, it's already there, but still maybe in one day we will have 6 hour shut off the electricity, yeah, for example, like that one. So it's very difficult. And if we want to implant implant something there, so we have a lot of obstacles. So that's why we need to have the independent environment that we can bring that. So in that time, we have the idea how if we just pull up the balloon, yeah. So that's why the G-Connect first. This is the early version in October 2016. We have this prototype. Yeah, this is my picture actually. Yeah, okay. So this is the balloon. It's very traditional balloon actually. He using the helium gas. And what the balloon? The balloon itself actually will be hang up the tools. Yeah, the hang up tools is like using the solar panel that will be the generator of the powers, and then will be placed into the power bank, something like that. And then the power bank will be supply the single port computer using the Raspberry Pi. And then there's single port computer or Raspberry Pi will be act as broadcaster and receiver of data connectivity. And then we will place the sensor in ground. So that's why the sensor will be transmit into the broadcaster and the receiver, and then will be collected by the SPC. So in this one, we also tied the balloon with the roof until the ground. So the balloon is only just like swing, but there is he will not go anywhere. Yeah, but unfortunately, after 1 month we operate, the balloon is gone. The balloon is gone, but the device still there. So yeah, someone is stiff the balloon, yeah, something like that lah. So because yeah, this is very expensive actually. The balloon, the first balloon, I still remember about 2.5 million. I think we built this one. We ordered from the workshop in the bundle. And then we still have the spirit, so we do the next, yeah, about Chilism, yeah. So the next is we build the second balloon. Yeah, this is the second prototype using like a concept of Zeppelin. You call it a Zeppelin balloon. Yeah, so you can see in here. We fly in December 2016, and unfortunately, it's already gone too. For 20 days, I think. Well, maybe not yet, but the worst is also the device is also gone. So yeah, and this is very it's very silly actually, but it's happened to us, yeah, in that. But yeah, about 30 days or 20 days that we fly the balloon, we get the data, but yeah, it's only 20 or 30 data. It will be like very small data, yeah. It's not good enough. Yeah, so this is the story. The first year is very sad. I think this is not work, and then we have a lot of loss. Yeah, this is more expensive because this is about, I think, 5 million in that time. So well, yeah, so it's very something. Yeah. And then the next is we do the next prototype. Yeah, so we place. I think the balloon is not work because not the technology, but not work because the people in there is not care about the tool. So we decide on to build a new tools is in the ground, and then we place the solar panel in here, and then we place the sensor inside the ground. You can see this one. This is the pipe that will be 10 meter under the ground to sensing the landslide from the ground. And also we have this sensor for temperature, humidity, and so on. And it's work, yeah. It's work in that time. And then we already have this dashboard. I think I will explain later. I will explain first about the tools, yeah. And then we also have the next generation of G-Connect in 2019, yeah. So actually it's same with this tools, yeah. We place a lot of sensor, but currently, wait a minute. Yeah, this one. Yeah, so this is my team in that previous time. Yeah, so we try to place a lot of sensor in here, still using the solar panel, but we add the video surveillance. Yeah, and then we'll be we send all the data into the server in the our lab. Yeah, in the actually it's not directly to the lab, but we place in the cloud first. We are using the Google Cloud platform, and then from the Google Cloud platform, I will download to the lab. So what we plan in that sensor? We using the environment sensor, using the temperature, humidity, wind, and landslide. Using the what they call it, the sensor in the smartphone, the accelerometer. Yes, the accelerometer sensor. And then using the surveillance, yeah, for image and CCTV. And then we also do the open data kit tools that will be combine all the data and then collect all data from the sensor and then bring together to the server. And then using the transmission media, we do the low rate bandwidth transmission. We compress the data first and then we go there. And then do the solar panel. And also we make to ensure that this device is not thief by people. Yeah. Yeah, so that will be the interesting one. So this is the dashboard, actually. I would like to see, okay. And what we have from this is like the architecture in that time. I'm sorry, this is the picture is not very clear, I think, yeah, but I will explain to you. When we do this scenario, we try to gather on the sensor and so on, we have a lot of research on it, yeah. When we built one tools, in that time, I can have about 7 theses that work together to build this project. Yeah. So, what they do? The first is thesis is working to analyze and then to decide which of the protocol that more appropriate for use between the Arduino that handle the sensor into the Raspberry Pi. Into the computers. So in that time, we compare and benchmark and do the analysis using the I2C and SPI protocol. Yeah. So you can see in here, it's very small things and very focused discussion. And we have the research in here. Yeah. So in that time, we decide that based on the research using the I2C. Yeah. And the I2C actually the common protocol that used for satellite communication to the Earth. Yeah. So that will be the next one. So when we understand about the protocol, we will understand about, oh, that's the form of data from the protocol, yeah, something like that. And then in the operating system itself, we also try to enhance the performance of operating system and scheduling. Yeah, so that will be also our main concern, because the Raspberry Pi actually is not good operating system for peak operation. Yeah, so that's why we need to enhance this capacity using the scheduling. And then we also try to using the like I said before, because the issue on data transmission, because a lot of data that want to transmit, so we need to compress and using the send algorithm, the sending algorithm that appropriate for this scenario. And also we combine with the scheduling to the cloud. Yeah. So we also using the algorithm to schedule and the data. And then in the storage itself, we using the extraction data and also the data correction. Why? Because sometimes a sensor is not work well. Yeah. Sometimes in 3 minutes, they also they can send the data, but unfortunately in the same time they busy and then they not send the data. So that's we need to correct the data. And then the rest is using the validation data. So in the in that time, based on the data, we have a lot of innovation from the public, from the social community in there. We do the crack observation. So in here we make like map, yeah. We place in many place in there to give the information based on our data we found in that village. We have 3 area that very dangerous, the main crack of the landslide. So if they live there, we suggest them to relocate here, yeah, even they doesn't want to relocate here. Yeah. So that's why it's one of the impact, yeah, for this research. So that's it. This is the team that worked with me. Yeah. Yeah, this is like field work, yeah, but very interesting for us. And then what we have, yeah, I will show you the dashboard. Hopefully in the work and the network is good enough. Okay, yeah, this one. Yeah, this is still, you can see in here, I have a portal data, we call it the karmabox.it /g_connect, yeah. Actually, in the number, we plan about 37 sensor or node for the about 3 and until 5 kilometer line, yeah, from the root of the crack. But unfortunately, today is only work for 7 or 4, I think, because the rest is already burnt by the landslide, yeah, something like that. So this is what happened in the area from the surveillance sensor, which is CCTV. We transmit this not as, you know, not as video, but as image frame. Yeah. So for each of image frame will be transmit, and then we will place like this one. So this is from the third, the three node. Yeah. And the first node, it will be in the Selopukang, is also in Selopukang in different place. You can see in here, yeah. So this is the our place, and if we go to the wait minute, yeah, this is the condition. But I inform you, this is not updated data because we have some problem in the access the data into the labs computer in the our labs, yeah, because you know sometimes the connection in the our campus is not welcome for a connection in outside, yeah. In here we can see that all the sensor will be placed together in here like this one, and then we will have the data from the sensor, from the temperature, and also from the anemometer, sensor sudut, and then so on. Yeah, I will answer to you. Okay, your question. I will show you the data that more. This one. So this is like the data that we have. Yeah. I will only snapshot what we have. Yeah. Okay. Wait a minute. Do you have any question? Wait a minute. Oh yeah, okay, yeah. That's the first one is like you can see the IoT data that not work well. Actually, this is the correct one. Actually, yeah. So you can see in here, this is like a stream data. Yeah, data from some date, for example, and then we have time, and every time is on our schedule, we will transmit to us as one package. Yeah, from the temperature and then the humidity. Anemometer is like, you know, some of the movement, yeah, and then the roll and the pitch. This is like for your wind, yeah? And then this is the, you know, speed x, speed y, and then speed z is like, you know, triangle. If we can see the differentiation, it means the landslide happened in there, yeah. So based on this is only the, you know, the data set, but after this we tune the some approach to analyze the data. And then this is only the temperature, this is the current condition, yeah, actually. And then this is the very dangerous if we have the kemiringan tanah, yeah. This is like the land will be collapsed, so we can see in here if we say 141, it mean like okay, it's like, you know, sangat curam begitu ya. So we'll be placed in there. So we can see in here also is same, yeah. And then this is the pergerakan tanah, and then this is pergerakan tanah. G is gravity actually, like G force, yeah. So if we have zero, minus, and this is plus, it means there is no differentiation, yeah. So that will be the next one. So, and then we also have this one. Wait a minute. Sorry, this is now. Yeah, this is the problem actually. When we access the analysis, it still have a problem because of the performance. So, okay, wait. We need to have lung. And currently, we already have, you know, the data from, I think, about, yeah, two years. So if you interest to join the project and then do some data science process and then to analyze the data and then you, you know, you came up with the, some algorithm to help us to define what happened with the data, it will be very nice, yeah. Because our objective now is done, because we want to collect the data. But the next agenda is how we analyze the data. So that's why we need the data scientist. So hopefully in the future, when you do your thesis, you can use the data from these activities. I have another activities with using COVID-19 data, so I will explain later. But you can use the data, and then because our lab still working on to establishing the data portal, yeah. So hopefully, if the data portal exists, you can access the data and then use for your thesis. So that's our work in the our labs, yeah. Sorry, this is like a very long because you know you still have need to query to lab SKC and then you still yeah and lab SKC is very slow today, so yeah. But actually, when you do that, you will have several parameters. So let's say even it's not very clear, but hopefully you know. Yeah, this one we can find you can show you your the graphic pattern, yeah. This is like the suhu and kelembapan. I'm sorry. It means we can see this one. There's we have a pattern in time series way. If we see this pattern, it's mean that the current situation is normal. But if we found this way, we have a two question. The sensor is doesn't work. It means it's limits or something happened in the field or landslide happened. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, and then yeah, so it's same with another visualization of the data from the anemometer, thermals, and also like another temp sensor. So if we found this pattern on the visualization, this display actually now consumed by PPPD and then some local government in there. So they already we have trained them to understand about the data, and if they see this data, they know what they do. So they will do some early warning announcement and then ask the people in there to you know to relocate in several time and then do something else. So the early warning is not like just like you know. Turn on the siren, the you know the sound that make people panic, yeah. And we also place in the some of the aula, yeah, some of the you know dorm in there that people can go there. So if in the morning if they want to go to the mountain to do their work, they will see that this dashboard and then see now the condition. So the next one. So sometimes. They call me and then say that, Pak Mardhani, I think it's good enough because we can see what happened in the future, and then we can go to the farm in the very convenient way. Yeah, so that will be the nice one. Yeah. So that's our challenge. So this is our next journey. I still have this agenda. Last year. We have a lot of pending because of pandemic, so we cannot go to the area directly. So that's why we still focus on the development of the tools. So now we develop a new sensor, new Internet of Things tools that more mobilized. So not implant in the fixed place. but we want to mobilize the tools, yeah, so it can be changed or we can move to another way, but still using the internet and then using the data center, using the data analytics, and then we have a lot of information in that. So if you would like to join, I will give you some information. Maybe next week we will have an open, you know, open opportunity for you, for the student that want to join our research. So it can be claimed for you as Campus Merdeka, and also you can also join for your thesis work. You can join for your experience in the campus. Yeah. So that will be. So this is another activity that we have done. Yeah. So we also have some disaster education, build some disaster kit, and then early warning system and so on. Yeah. This is what your friend do, disaster education, and then we also using the family disaster kit, and then yeah, this is the collection of the data. We using the pandemic survey. And then, yeah, many things to do. This is the development, the deployment. Yeah, so yeah, it's very very nice actually when we go to the field and then we can deploy our own tools and then we gather our own data. Yeah, and then yeah, that's very nice. I'm sorry. Yeah. So yeah, this is a good one. Okay. So that's the you know the and the use case or case study that I want to share with you about the project. Yeah, hopefully you get the point, and then you understand that, yeah, you realize that data is very important, and then it's very hard to collect the data in the real world. So you need to understand as data scientist. Yeah. Okay. Any question about it, please.